Hi, my name's Malcolm. I'm 16 and I live in a mining village called Pilsley. I want to tell you a story of something that happened to me a few months ago. Even now I can't sleep at nights. It's hard to believe you can go from being a boy to a man in 24 hours. I did, and this is my story.
It's 1966. The music is fantastic. There's a whole lot of love around, but there is also a sense that the world is changing. John Lennon has just declared that the Beatles are more famous than Jesus. And America vowed to fight communism by sending more troops to Vietnam. Meanwhile, in London, Ronnie and Reggie Cray, the underworld gangsters, are busy murdering people who threaten their empire. But this is worlds apart from us. We live in a sleepy mining village with very little changes. Our news isn't nearly as exciting. Our world is a simple one, because we live in a single occupation community. This means the men go to work down the mines and us women look after them. We are surrounded by mines. There are at least five in this area alone, and our lives and routines are governed by them. In its own way, life is still exciting. We have money, jobs for life, and a cracking community spirit. But sometimes, things don't always go to plan. When things go wrong down a mine, it's usually very bad news. Malcolm is starting work today after spending the last few months at Grassmoor Training Centre. He's with his mates and the girls at the local club. Things are looking up for him. Why? Because he is now a working miner.
Hi, my name is Stephen and I'm going off to university. My dad John's a miner, and although he doesn't really understand about me going to university, he is still willing to let me go. I'm breaking the family tradition of going down the mines and instead looking forward to the long term, where I can get a degree from university and be earning loads of money.
Hi, my name's Susan and my job is to help my mum and look after the little ones and help her babysit. I'm looking for a part-time job and hopefully when I'm older I'll marry a miner. And we haven't really got many options around here because it's a mining community. That's it.
Hi, it's me again, Malcolm. Did I tell you that all my family and friends were miners and I'm continuing that proud tradition? It's in our blood.
People who live outside a mining community sometimes struggle to understand the tight-knit nature of our community. But the fact is, we look after our own. Everyone is in the same boat. We work hard, go through the same struggles, and then socialise together at the weekends. We do this by meeting up at the Miners' Welfare. This is the hub of our community.
I think this area, at the heart of the mining peak, if you like, I remember, because we're on edge of it, everybody used to have to catch a bus to either Markham or Shirebrook, and there used to be out up to 20 buses sort of in the morning at 5 o'clock and dropping off at between 2 and 3 o'clock. And I remember all the miners going off the buses at the Alma and walking down street, up to 30 people, and disappearing into all the houses, because everybody on Alma Estate then worked at Pitt, I think. I think over the years, I think things have changed quite significantly from when I was a kid. And like I say, I remember that nearly everybody on Alma Estate used to have a job that everybody worked at the pits, William Thorpe, Holmwood, and Markham, Arkwright. But as time's gone on, obviously, the pits have shut. The Alma Estate now is, I think most people are either retired or on income support or things like that. So it has changed the whole atmosphere of that estate and even the village. And again, Claycross Works shutting had an impact as well. So, but people have still got jobs, but they have to travel further and it's not as well paid, I don't think, either. The village has also changed because we've got quite a lot of private houses and people can commute using the motorways and stuff. I mean, I remember when I was a kid really, we used to have to be down at welfare for 7 o'clock to get a table Friday and Saturday night. and majority of people in village used to come, and it were a build on from the pit. Same men who worked together down pit had meet up in welfare with the families Friday and Saturday night, and also some nights in week. So it were quite pivotal to the community, I think.
Malcolm's thoughts now turn to the day ahead.
So here I am, walking to work with my Uncle John. He's the one who got me the job down the mine. I suppose he's the closest uncle I've got, always looking after us when we were kids. I'm really looking forward to today. Should be fun. People might try and play practical jokes on me, but I'll be ready for them. Not been to training college for nothing. I think I will make a good miner. Just need to listen to others a bit more and work hard. Mining is in my family's blood and I'm a fit lad, so it should be okay. This walk to work is fantastic. I'm very lucky.
The locker areas where you got changed to get ready for mining were a playground. People used to act about and joke about with all different people, telling them the experiences of being in pub night before, playing football, watching telly, you name it, it was spoken about.
I think the locker room situation were the worst bit for me. You'd go to work on with your clean clothes on and have to take them off and walk through to mucky sod just with a towel and a bar of soap, and then you had to put on all your old sweaty, dinky clothes from the day before, and that were it. Then you knew your shift had started. I didn't like that bit.
You are entering a contraband zone. Please leave your contraband with the lamp room attendant before going underground.
There was a ritual each day that miners followed. It helped prepare them for the difficult job ahead. The changing rooms had a dirty and a clean side. More modern mines introduced bathhouses. After getting changed, miners would pick up their safety lamps and prepare for the day ahead. Part of the routine was a search for any illegal contraband, mainly cigarettes and matches. This would happen before going underground. To Malcolm, this was another world. He would soon get used to it. But for now, there was a small issue of practical jokes.
Hey up, lad, it's your first day. Watch out, nobody plays any tricks on you. They'll have to be up early morning to catch me out. Do us a favour, mate. When you get out at stores, fetch me a new bubble for my spirit level.
No problem. So I need a bubble for a spirit level.
Malk, you off to the stores? Do us a favour and bring me a tin of tartan paint.
Okay, so that's a bubble for a spirit level and a tin of tartan paint. I think I can remember that.
Oh, by the way, whilst you're at it, grab me a left-handed screwdriver.
So it's a bubble for a spirit level, a tin of tartan paint and a left-handed screwdriver. No problem, I'm on my way.
I forgot, Mark. One other thing, whilst you're down at the stores, ask for a long stand.
Good job on writing this down. Okay, so it's a bubble for your spirit level, a tin of tartan paint, and a left-handed screwdriver, and a long stand. Hi, I'm new here. Are you the storeman?
Aye.
Can I have a bubble for your spirit level, a tin of tartan paint, a left-handed screwdriver, and a long stand, please?
You certainly can, son. Just you wait there.